In this chapter, we'll be discussing about types of bonds. So normally when we say bonds in India, it means bonds issued by public sector units and other financial institutions. Corporate bonds means bonds that are issued by companies. Okay. Sovereign bonds can also be there. That is, those are issued by government or RBI. So bonds are issued by a variety of entities. It can be companies, it can be public sector units, it could be even government, state governments or a central government. So let us see some types of bonds. One is fixed rate bond. Fixed rate bonds, and most of the government bonds are issued as fixed rate bond. Fixed rate bond means the coupon rate, that is the interest rate, is fixed for the entire life of the bond. For example, GS 2018 8.24%, that is the name of a bond. This is how bonds are, this is how the nomenclature of the bonds go on. It means this bond is issued on April 22nd 2008 for a tenor of 10 years, maturing on April 22, 2018. Coupon on the security will be paid half yearly on October 22nd and April 22nd of each year. So here the coupon rate 8.24% is fixed for this 10 years period. 10%, that is a fixed rate, will be paid on the face value of the bond. So these are fixed rate bonds. Then there's something called floating rate bonds. These bonds don't have a fixed coupon rate. The coupon is reset at, so pre-announced intervals, it will be fixed, reset. Say for example, every 6 months, once in every 6 months. So when discussing about facilities available given to companies, there we discuss base rate and other floating rate of interest, but discuss this in the case of housing loans. Okay, so just like that, here our spread is added to some benchmark rate. Okay, like say a treasury bill, 364 treasury bill, there will be some benchmark, and over that we'll be taking some spread, and that will be reset at periodic intervals. Okay, so those are floating rate bonds. So here the coupon rate keeps changing. Then there's something called zero coupon bonds. Zero coupon bonds have no coupon payments, 0% interest. So then you might ask, why would people buy them? It's like say 1,000 rupees bond for 5 years tenor. At the end of the 5 years, you'll be getting back 1,000. So what is the fun in paying 1,000 and getting back 1,000 after 5 years? So here the trick is to compensate for this lack of interest coupon. These bonds are issued at discount, just like T-bills, which we'll discuss in a later chapter. Okay, say for example, when the face value is say 1,000, they might issue it for 920 or 930. So you're offering at a discount. So even though you don't get the coupon payment, at the end of the maturity period, you'll be getting back 1,000. But how much you paid at the time of issuing? Just 920, 930. So in that way, you're compensated for the risk rather than periodic payments. Okay. By the way, government is not issuing zero coupon bonds these days. Okay. And you may also hear the term called deep discount bonds, which is just the same as zero coupon bonds. Then there are some bonds called capital index bonds. These bonds, the principal amount is linked to some index like the wholesale price index, and this protects the investors from inflation. Then there are bonds with call and put options. So in these bonds, there will be an option for, one option is the government can buy back. That's a call option, right? So even before the maturity period, the government can buy back the bond from the investor. The second option, the investor can sell the bond to the government during the tenure of the bond. There are two options. So then there are convertible bonds. These call and put options we have come across in under risk management when we're discussing about derivatives. So just like options, there are call and put options. The same concept here also. Bonds can be have an option of call and put options. Then there are convertible bonds. Convertible bonds means the bondholder will be having an option to convert the bonds into equity. Bonds and equity are two separate instruments, totally different. Bond is a debt instrument, whereas equity is a sort of ownership. But convertible bonds will be having an option to convert the bonds to equity. So as a bondholder, you'll be having an option, if you want, to convert this bond into a share. If you feel that share is more attractive, you can opt for the conversion. Okay. So in this chapter, the questions will be prepared out. Who normally issues bonds? So governments, companies, state governments, municipal bodies. Okay. All of these issue bonds. So what are corporate bonds, what are sovereign bonds, fixed rate bonds, floating rate bonds, zero coupon bonds, capital index bonds, bonds with call and put options, convertible bonds, all these have we have discussed.